Hello and welcome to our second day of our environmental science lab. Our lesson objectives for today will be to list the points that make up the scientific method. We will discuss hypothesis testing, and we will plot data and graph a best fit line. Okay, here we have the scientific method, and it's the same one you did in grade school, except we added a few more points for college. We, of course, asked a question. We formulate a hypothesis. We run experiments. And we collect accumulated scientific data. Now, before I go all the way through the scientific method, we're going to stop here and we're going to test our hypothesis. View data in a scatter plot and graph a best fit line. We wanted to see if there was a correlation between a person's arm length and their height. That was our hypothesis. So we had five classmates, and with me that made six. And we measure everybody's arm length, which is the first column here highlighted. Then we measure everyone's height, which is the second column that's highlighted. And we wanted to graph this data. So the arm length was our y-axis, and the height we graphed on the x-axis. So here's our graph, and here are the points on the graph. Now, many of you may be used to points in algebra where they may be in a linear setup, but here the data pretty much throws your points all over, and this is what we call a scatter plot. And what we do to graph these is we have a best fit line. Well, we try to get the line to get as close to the data points as possible. It's not going to be perfect. And the way we try to find out how the data is related, since it's not in a line, is we want to find the slope of that data. And again, many of y'all may remember from algebra, we had to rise over run. We had to find the change in the y-coordinate over the change in the x-coordinate. And here's the formula right here. Well, we have y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. But we can't use this formula because these points are not on the same line. So pretty much what we're going to do is just simply get the slope of each point. We're going to have y, and we're going to divide it by x. So we go back to our original data, and of course the arm length is y, the height is x, and we divide y by x, and here, as you can see in the highlighted portion, is what we get for our slope. And you can see most of those slopes are pretty much close together in value. Now, here is our average slope value. Okay, now let's go back to our graph. And here's one of our best fit lines. Now, notice how everything is close to that line except for this point. With this being such an anomaly, as you can see here, compared to all the other ones, we may just go ahead and just remove that out of our data. Okay, so now we go back to our scientific method, and we've at this point collected the accumulated scientific data. We can revise the original hypothesis. Next, we make our conclusion. We didn't do that here. We pretty much just showed how to graph the data. We never really analyzed it. But the last thing to do is to publish your results for a peer review. Your other students need to look at it, your professor, department heads, professors from other institutions. They may want to share your data, or you may want to look at theirs. And that is it for this video.